He sat in that long line of barber chairs, and the sergeant asked him, "Son, would you like to keep your hair?" He said, "Yes, sir," as he heard those clippers buzz and hum. And the sergeant said, "Well, hold out your hands, 'cause here it comes. Simplify, do or die. So gung ho to go and pay the price."
Hey everybody, it's Crystal Clear 101 here with another toy review, and today I have one per request from a recent subscriber, Silviano Marquez. I apologize if I mispronounce your name, but he asked in the Marine Assault 4 video if I could do a review on the defense bunker. Well, this is gonna be my review of the U.S. Marines defense bunker by its site. First off, here is the front of the packaging. And just like with the Assault 4-wheeler, here's a hologram right down here saying that this is an officially licensed product of the United States Marine Corps. Here is the side of the packaging. And here is the reverse side of the packaging. It says the same thing down here about the Marines, about the beginning of the Marines. If you want to know what that says, check out the video about the Assault 4-wheeler. Matter of fact, I will have a link to that video in the description box below, so you can go check that out. The reverse side, as I said, this is by its site. Alright, now with that being said, let me go ahead and break this out, and let's see how decent this little set is. Be back in just a sec. Now here is this entire set out of the packaging. Well, first off, let's go ahead and start off with the Marine itself. Now, just like with the Assault 4-wheeler, this is just a basic generic Marine. The only difference is that while the Assault 4-wheeler had more of a white, a Caucasian type Marine, this one's supposed to be more of a African American type Marine. I would almost say that this is the same mold. However, there are some slight differences between this one and the one that came with the Assault 4-wheeler. Number one, if I remember, I think this hip holster was a little more to the side. I could be mistaken. I don't recall there being a little combat knife down towards the bottom of the left leg. The arms are very similar. It's almost like this one was also intended to ride the four-wheeler. I'm sure you could, but if you've seen the review for the Assault 4-wheeler, I had a hard time getting that one to ride it. Another thing is, it does come with this removable backpack. However, without it, I mean, he just looks very bare in the back. I mean, there is some detail work, but to me, without the backpack, he just looks really bare. The only differences I can really tell you, aside from this and the other set, aside from the skin color of this Marine, is the different accessory, which is the bunker, which I will get to in just a moment. The only other difference aside from that is the primary weapon. The Marine for the last set had an M4A1. This one comes with a paratrooper version of the M249 SAW. And this does have extending bipod. Now, it holds very awkwardly in his right hand. Matter of fact, the way it's made, it looks like he's just one hand in the weapon. Which I would like to see someone actually do with the M249. But, you know, it's a saw. It's a nice little accessory. But, aside from that, it's very similar to the previous set, albeit with a couple of minor changes. But this is the main attraction of the set right here, is this bunker, this little defense bunker. Now, what's interesting to note is that this is three individual pieces. And as far as the quality of the plastic itself, from the texture, it feels like it would be kind of a cheap material. To be honest, it does feel kind of cheap. but at the same time, it is actually fairly sturdy. It does have some flex to it, but that's always a good thing. That means it's not gonna break if you apply too much pressure to it. These walls are adjustable. You can either have them all the way out, or you can have them at just about 90 degree angles, but at that point they're just going to pop out, or just about pop out. Now what's interesting to note is that each segment has square shaped peg holes. One in the center, two on the left side or the right side if you're behind it, and three on this side over here. Now if you remember the comically enlarged MP5 from the other set, this does come with that. However, the neat thing is that you can actually mount this in any one of those six positions. And basically you didn't give this a mounted weapon, a mounted defense weapon. And the good thing is that I have no real issues getting this to go into any of the holes, except for right here. It's just a little tight. But the point is, you can actually mount this into the holes and give your bunker a defense weapon, almost like a machine gun defense position. But aside from that, it's got a sticker up here. It says United States Marine Corps. It's only done on this side. It's just blank on the other side. It doesn't even have this little texture corner on the back side, as you can see. But as I said with the Assault 4-wheeler, if you don't care for the Marine or the accessories, the bunker itself is at least decent. You can use this for another 3¾-inch figure. I don't know if you want to do like a military diorama of some kind. If you want to do a G.I. Joe diorama, then this is good for that. But the bunker itself, I actually do like. Weapons and accessories for the set include an M249 squad automatic weapon, a paratrooper version, which does show some decent detailing, and a functioning bipod. An H&K MP5A5 submachine gun, which is comically enlarged, which could be mounted on the bunker itself in one of six positions, giving additional display options. An Israeli Uzi submachine gun. A generic single-action revolver, which appears to be based on the Colt single-action army with a telescopic sight. A generic double-action revolver, which to me appears to be based off of Vash the Stampede's revolver from Trigun. A generic semi-automatic pistol, which to me appears to be based on a Smith & Wesson Model 59. And lastly, a cell phone. An articulation for this Marine action figure consists of a swivel head, swivel shoulders, and swivel hips. But what is my overall verdict on the Marine's defense bunker by its site? Just as with the Assault 4-wheeler, this is worth every bit of its retail of, $4.99 to $5. And even if you don't care for the Marine, if you don't care for the weapons, the accessories, it still comes with a very, very nice little bunker that you can either use with a G.I. Joe or you use with another 1:18 scale military action figure for dioramas, displays, and stuff like that. But if you love Marines, if you love anything military, then do consider picking this one up. This is actually not that bad. The bunker itself is actually a fairly nice, sturdy little piece. And on top of that, the Marine, despite his limited articulation, he still shows some fairly nice details. But that'll wrap up my review on its size U.S. Marine Corps defense bunker. Be sure to rate, comment, and subscribe.